A very good morning to class 5th. As you know, yesterday we have completed our exercise 13.3. In this exercise, you learned about how to find the volume of cube and cuboid, right? And how to convert the capacity into volume and volume to capacity. Clear? Now, for today, we will do the worksheet of the chapter 13. In this worksheet, there are 6 questions. And these 6 questions are the mixture of 13.1, 2 and 3. So, in this worksheet, whatever you learn in these 3 exercises, this is the complete 6 questions from these 3. So, first of all, everyone knows what is the difference between the area and the volume, right? So, let's restart our exercise. So, the first question is, a rectangular park is 50 meter by 30 meter. So, this word 50 meter by 30 meter will represent the length of the park is length of the park is 50 meter and breadth is 30 meter, right? So this is the park which is rectangular in the shape. This one is length, which is 50 meter. This is the breadth, which is 30 meter. Right? Now, come to the second line. A path 4 meter wide is built all around its outside. Outside means outer this. So, we will take it like this. 4 meter wide. This path is created around the or built around the park. The length and breadth, see, 4 meter from this side and 4 meter from this side. Clear, students? So total length is 58 meter. Right? 58 meter this side and 58 meter this side. Reason, rectangular park and in rectangle opposite sides are equal. Right? And everyone knows the meaning of opposite. Means, aamne saamne jo sides hain, like this to this. Now, this is the length. Come to the breadth. See, this one is the breadth. From this side also it is 4 meter and from this side also it is 4 meter. So total increment in the breadth is 8 meter. So this is 38 meter. Right? So firstly we will find the area of the park. Area of park. Formula. Length multiply breadth. 50 multiply 30. Unit meter square. So this become 5 threes are 15 and 2 zeros meter square. Clear? Now, path. Length. How much? 50. 8 meter. Breadth. Meter. Right? Now we have to find the area of path with park. because see, in this the length of park is also include. We have to find the separate area of the path. So separate area, when it come out, when from the total you will subtract the area of this path. From this complete one, if I subtract the area of this one, then I will find the area of the this remaining part. Clear? So same processor we will apply in these type of sum. Firstly, we will find the area of the bigger one, bigger rectangle, and after that the area of the smaller rectangle. So you will write here area of big rectangle. Again, that is length multiply breadth, which is 58 multiply 38 meter square. Now when we multiply these two, it comes 2204 meter square. Clear? This is the area of the bigger rectangle. Now come to the next line, that is find the cost of constructing the path at the rate rupees 300 per meter square. Means now we have to find the area of path, and again area of path equals to area of big rectangle minus the area of park, or you can write here small rectangle. So how much area of path, sorry, area of big rectangle, 2204 meter square minus area of park 1500 meter square, right? When we subtract it, our answer is 704 meter square. Right? Once again, if I subtract the area of the bigger one and the smaller one, then I get the area of this, right? This remaining part, which is the area of path. So 704 meter square is area of the path. Now I have to find the cost of the area, that is rupees 300 per meter square. So cost of 1 meter square path is rupees 300. Right? Now cost of 704 meter square path, it simply means rupees 300 multiply with 704, and when you multiply you get the amount, or you can say the cost of 704 meter square path. Clear the first question to everyone? Now come to the second question, that is again a rectangular park is 70 meter by 50 meter. A path 5 meter wide is built all around inside it. So in this question, I will just explain this question and you will do it yourself. Clear, students? I am just explaining this how you have to do. See, one rectangular park is given here, that is 70 meter by 50 meter. It means this is 70 meter and this one is 50 meter, right? means length is 70 meter and breadth is 50 meter. Now second line is, so according to first line, what you will do, you will find the area of the park. Now come to second one. A path 5 meter wide is built all around inside it, means inside this one. And this is 5 meter wide, means this one, right? Five meter from this side. So, look, students, in the first question, inside given, outside you have to find with the adding. But now, outside is given and we have to find the measurement of inside one. So, what you will do? From this, we will subtract these. That is 70 minus 5 minus 5 equals to 60 meter. So, this one is 60 meter. Right? Why I subtract? Because if 5 meter wide from this side and 5 meter wide from this side, then what is the length left here? That is 60 meter. Same for breadth. If 50 meter is complete one, 5 from this side, 5 from this side, then this will be 40 meter. Right? So firstly, find the area of park or big rectangle. Then find the area of small rectangle, right? And now you have to find the area of path. So what is the area of path now? From the big one to the small one, means area of big rectangle minus area of small rectangle. Clear? After that, the cost given here is ₹250 per meter square. So you will find the area of the path with the cost of ₹250. So clear the second question to everyone. It is very easy. You will do the calculation yourself. Complete, I told you. Now the third one. A floor 7 meter long and 5 meter broad is to be covered with square tiles of size 25 centimeter. Find the number of tiles it needed. So, in question number 3, we have to find number of tiles. Right? Number of tiles. For this, just remember about the exercise 13.2. In which exercise that we learn how to find the number of tiles. So formula is area of floor divided by the area of one tile. Right? So it means on the basis of this formula, first what we have to find? We have to find the area of floor. So for floor, length is 7 meter, broad means breadth, that is 5 meter. Now area of floor, 7 multiply 5, or you can write the formula first, that is length multiply breadth, unit square. 7 5s are 35 meter square. Clear? Now, the tile to be covered with side. For tiles, see, this tile is of square shape, means all side are equal. So students, look at this. The floor area unit is meter square, but in the tiles the unit is given here centimeter. So what we do, we will convert this. 1 meter square equals to 10,000 centimeter. Now 35 meter square equals to 10,000 multiply with 35, that is 350,000, right, centimeter square. Now the units of floor and tile is same, so area of tile, that is side multiply side, 25 multiply with 25, and it is equals to 625 centimeter square. Now you have to find the number of tiles, then write down the formula and put the values in that. At the place of area of floor, 350,000 centimeter square, and area of tile 625 centimeter square. Unit cut by unit, and this 350,000 divide by 625, and you will get the number of tiles. Clear to everyone? Calculation you will do yourself. Now the next fourth question is, find the volume of a box in the shape of cuboid with length 40 cm, breadth 20 cm and height 10 cm. So what is the formula of cuboid? Length multiply breadth multiply height. What is the formula? Length multiply breadth multiply height. Right? And unit is centimeter cube. So you will multiply first length multiply with breadth, 40 multiply 20, then multiply with 10. And the product come, that is the answer of question number 4. Now the question number 5. Find the volume of a box is in the shape of cube. Now cube in which all sides are equal or all edges are equal. Sides means edges and edges means side. They both are the same with the different name. So students, don't get confused beta. When I say about edges, it means there also I am talking about the sides. So what is the edge side given? 20 centimeter, right? So formula of volume of cube, side multiply side multiply side. So put the values in the formula and do the question. Now come to the sixth question, that is the last one. A water tank is in the shape of cuboid with length 30 meter, breadth 20 meter and depth 5 meter. Find the capacity of the tank in liters. So it means what we will do, firstly we will find the volume of the tank and then we will convert that volume into liter, right? Now look at this question, question number 6. Firstly, length of tank. What is the length? 30 meter. Then breadth of tank, that is 20 meter. Now depth means that is the height of tank, 5 meter. Clear? Now what we have to find the volume of tank, that is length multiply breadth multiply height, which is 30 multiply 20 multiply 5 meter cube. So 3 2s are 6, 6 5s are 30, and 2 zeros as it is. It means 3000 meter cube. Now the next question is, find the capacity of the tank in liter. So it means we know that 1 meter cube equals to 1000 liter, right? So this 3000 meter cube equals to multiply with 1000 liter, and the answer that come is 30 lakh liter, right? So you may write like this, capacity of tank is 30 lakh liter. Clear, students? So this is the last question of your exercise, worksheet 13. Now with this question the worksheet is over, and on Monday is your test of chapter 13. So everyone be ready for that, and if anyone have any problem in this chapter 13, you can comment and ask.